Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can make spiral brushes and ornaments in Photoshop. Before we start with this tutorial, I'm going to show you what we're aiming for. And this is the kind of spiral I'm going to show you how to create in Photoshop. And then having created it, I'm going to show you how you can use some circular processes to actually create other pieces of art from this particular spiral. And I'm also going to show you how you can create a brush using it. So I'm just going to close these two images down to start off with, and let's go and get ourselves a new file. So I'll choose File, New, and I'm just doing a 600 by 600 pixel image. It's 72 pixels per inch resolution with a white background. And of course, we're working in RGB color mode. Just going to click OK. Now I'm going to select the elliptical marquee tool. It shares a toolbar position here with the rectangular marquee tool. I'm going to click on the elliptical marquee tool to select it and drag out a circle. And to do this, I'm going to hold the shift key as I drag the circle. And this is going to be my starting point. I'm going to add a new layer because I want this to be on a brand new layer. And I'm going to select a new foreground color. I'll choose this sort of pinky orange. And because I'm on a new layer and because the color I want to use is the frontmost color and I have a selection in place, I'm going to press Alt Backspace Option Delete on the Mac to fill that circle with this color. I'm now going to select the Move tool because this is the tool I'm going to use to move and reshape this shape into a spiral. With the Move tool selected, I'm going to press Ctrl or Command T, which is the Transform tool. I'm going to change where we're going to rotate through because I want this shape to rotate around a sort of circle to make a spiral. So I'm just going to drag this rotation point out somewhere. And then I want this shape to get smaller as it goes. So I'm going to click the link button here and I'm going to type 90% in here. So the shape is going to be reduced each time to 90% of the size that it was the previous time. And I want a pretty good rotation, so I'm going to choose 30 degrees. And you can see that the shape has now moved, it's shrunk, and it has transformed through 30 degrees. I'm going to click the check mark to confirm that transformation. And to now repeat it, I'm going to press Ctrl Alt Shift and then the letter T for transform. Every time I tap the letter T with Ctrl Alt and Shift selected, the shape is transformed around that point. Its size is reduced to 90% of its previous size and it's rotated 30 degrees. And I can keep going as long as I want to until I get the spiral that I'm looking for. I think I'll stop about here. And here is the spiral shape on a new layer. And because it's on a new layer, I can now do things with it. So I'm going to select the Move tool and Control click on the layer thumbnail so that I can select the shape as an entire object. Now one thing I can do with it is to resize it and perhaps arrange it into a different arrangement. So I'm going to quickly add some guides to the image by just dragging in the guides. And then I'm going to move this shape out so that it's in one of these areas. Now it's a little bit bigger than it needs to be for this size image, so I'm holding the shift key as well as just sizing it a little bit smaller. And I'll click the check mark and press Ctrl D to deselect the selection. Now this is going to form the beginnings of my shape, but I'd also like it to be a brush. So I'm just going to choose Edit and then Define Brush Preset because we're going to make it into a brush before we go. So I'll just click OK. Now that it is a shape, I can rotate it around this point to create a circle. So again, with the Move tool selected, I'm going to press Ctrl or Command T to transform it. I'm going to set this point here as my transformation point. So that's the image's top left point. So I'm selecting that here. I want to rotate it so that I get four shapes. So each one of them has to be rotated 90 degrees. And I'll click the check mark. And now I'll press Ctrl Alt Shift T three times to create my transformed shape. Now each of these has appeared on a new layer, so I'm going to just select all three layers and press Ctrl or Command E to merge them into one layer. As you can see, the shape that we've created is a little bit bigger than our image. We can solve that problem by choosing Image and then Reveal All. And that just resizes our image so that we can see the entire shape. I'm now going to drag the shape layer onto the new layer icon, so I've created a second shape. Again, with the Move tool selected, this time I'm going to rotate this shape through around 45 degrees. So I'm looking for 45 degrees up here, and if I can't get it exactly, I'm just going to type 45. And I'm not really liking that result, so let's try 30. I think that looks better, so I'm just going to click the check mark. And now I could recolor this shape if I wanted to. I'll lock the pixels on this layer. I'll go and get my orange color, and this time let's choose a lighter orange color. And because the lighter orange color is my foreground color and I have this particular layer selected, I can Alt Backspace or Option Delete to fill the layer with this color. Because I have the lock icon selected, only the colored pixels are actually going to be filled with this new color. I'm going to unlock it, and now let's go to Image Reveal All because we want to see this shape. And I'm going to do the same thing over again. I'm going to duplicate the shape. This time I might size it a little bit smaller, so I'm holding down the Alt and Shift keys as I resize the shape, and now let's rotate it. Let's try 30 degrees again. I'm thinking that might work, so I'll click the check mark. Again, I'm going to lock these pixels. Again, I'm going to select a color to use. I think this time I'm going to use a deeper red. And again, Alt Backspace Option Delete to color it. And I could keep on going creating this effect. I can also add a new color into the background. So I'm going to select black and just press Alt Backspace to fill the background with black. And we could either continue by using the same size object, or we could create smaller and smaller objects if we want to. I'll press Ctrl and the semicolon to just hide these grid lines so that we can see what we've got. And let's have a look too at the brush that we created. I'm going to choose and create a new image. I want the image to have a black background color, but right now I can't do that, so I'm just going to click OK. And because black is my foreground color, I'll press Alt Backspace to make a black background. I'm going to add a new layer. I'm going to select my brush tool, so I'm going to click on the brush tool, and my brush is going to be the very, very last of the lot. So here it is here, so I'm going to click on it to select it. I'm going to click a color to paint with, and now we can see that we can brush on this brush. Now I have the opacity set really low. I can increase the opacity and paint with this brush. We can do all sorts of things with it as a brush. I like to create brushes from many of the shapes that I create just so that I have some flexibility later on to perhaps use the brush to do something with, as well as using the shape itself for some other effect. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more of my tutorials on this YouTube channel. If you subscribe to my YouTube channel, you'll be advised when new video tutorials are released. And visit my website at projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Illustrator, Photoshop Elements, Lightroom, and a whole lot more.